What? Oh my goodness. I've never seen that happen. That, how? Okay. You guys saw that? What in the world? How did a zombie, a regular zombie, just spawn in the Nether? Never seen this before in my life. Unbelievable. Like, I almost want to keep this guy. He's rare, but yeah, he's just a zombie. Hey everyone, it's your friend Think Noodles, and welcome back to my Let's Play. And we're gonna do something a little interesting, a little bit of a build. But first, I saw a lot of comments that really wanted me to take my looting blade to the next level, make it sharpness 5. So I looked through all my chests here, and I found two sharpness 4 books. So we should, assuming that the anvil holds up, we should be able to get a sharpness 5 out of that. And then, yes, plenty of levels, and it allowed it. Sweet, 13.25 attack damage, and now it's fully, like, okay. And, oh, you know the other thing I wanted to do? Oh yeah, hold on. I realized that my bow is awesome. However, we can make it a little bit more awesomer. So here we go. How come it doesn't repair it like the other one did? That was weird. I don't... Okay, whatever. Anyway, awesome bow is... There goes my anvil. Fine, I don't care. I got plenty of iron. So now we've got Unbreaking 3, Infinity 1, Power 5, Flame 1. Yep, pretty much an awesome bow. So, I have been in the interim working on my Wither Skeleton farm. Well, not really the farm itself, but just slabbing and slabbing and slabbing. So what we're going to do today, you guys see I have some slime balls in my inventory, and, well, I don't have enough of them. I want to use slime blocks quite a bit, and I don't really have a way of getting them. I guess I'll put it here. Sure, that's good. What I have decided to do is, I remember seeing a lot of people created slime farms way, way back, you know, maybe 1.5, and I was like, why? I mean, really, how many slime balls do you need? I mean, sticky pistons, yeah, but honestly, like, how useful are slimes? Well, they're useful now, as you guys can tell. I want some, and where did you come from? Would you get out of here? Okay. So anyway, this is probably not lit enough. I'm guessing he spawned here. I wanted to create a slime farm, and I learned a little bit. I looked at XI Sumavoid's slime farm tutorial, and that's what I'll be using this basis for. I'll put a link in the description to give him credit. It's pretty cool. And he referenced something called a slime chunk finder. So I'll put a link to the website in the description. But what you can do is enter your seed, and it will show you which chunks, which is in your X and Z, are programmed to spawn slimes, and that's below Y equals 40. And in those, slimes will spawn at any light level, which is key, because what that means is if they are set in if you build this quote unquote farm in the slime chunk, the only thing you're going to get spawning is slimes. So you don't have to worry about other mobs spawning and stuff. So anyway, I identified a slime chunk right over here, and there are a lot of them, actually. I didn't even realize. But in X336 to 352 and Z minus 96 to minus 112. So 336. I don't have a big axe. Oh geez, you know, it's one of those days, guys. I don't know. But anyway, so we're gonna build an area just to sort of spawn slimes and sort of coax them into some cacti, and they'll die, and then it'll pick them up. We don't want to use fortune. We don't want fortune. We don't want fortune. How come everything I have is fortune? Ugh, is there anything here? Man, come on. I've been running out of pickaxes. Because of going through that Nether area. I guess I'll use the efficiency. I mean, I have a ton of these efficiency 4 fortune 3s. I hate using a fortune pickaxe. We'll use the fortune 2. All right. Although we have to cut out a lot. I don't know. All right. Well, whatever. Anyway, we're going to go over this way and we're going to mine out 336. Let me see. 336 to 352. So we need to go further this way. So starting right here. Oh, yep. 336. So I'm going to mark that. And then we go to, let's see. So we're going toward negative X and we need to be negative 96. So that's actually not the place I want to mark as the corner of the farm. And we do need to mine out around it, but 336. And so here we go with the edge right here, 336 comma 96. And that is the edge of the spawn chunk or slime chunk, which means that anywhere below level 40 that exists or that's open and spawnable, a slime can spawn there at any light level, which means, you know, if you light it up enough, spawns will slime. Slimes will spawn and nothing else will. So that is the goal. And of course we have to go, is it this way? Yes. So as you guys can see right here, that and that, we're at 0, 0, and then we go to 0, 1, and this goes to 15. So we have to go to 0, comma 15. So all the way to there, which is the same. Oh man, do I have a shovel? Yes, okay. Which is the same as well, what did I say it was? To 352. So we'll just keep it going, and I'll dig out, I guess. The square for you guys, and then I'm gonna go and do some off-camera work to expand it, because it needs to be expanded both up and down to make the farm more efficient, obviously. I don't know how far into it I want to go, so as you guys can see, so I miscalculated it. I went too far there. 352 right here, so as you guys can see, 15, so I actually put it right on the right spot. It should be to 351, because, yeah, so there it is. So we go from 0 in the Z, that little 0 in the parentheses, all the way to the 15 in the parentheses, right? And then so we'll just mark it there with a cobble. And, yep, and then we'll go this way. And we should, oh, we have to be in a block. Man, all right, so in taking down those numbers, I didn't take them down appropriately. There we go. So this is correct. This is the same chunk because this is outside that chunk and this is inside that chunk. So we don't want this. We want this. Ugh, I am so sorry, guys, for confusing you. But if you download this in after I'm done with this, and I'm sure with my wither farm, you guys will get this and you won't have to do anything. But if you're trying to build this for yourself, you want to go see 15 comma 15 and in one corner. And then the other one, we're going to go to the 0, 0 mark. Put one there. And this is good too. Another reason I'm doing this is it's a good way to get the slime blocks that we want. And it's also a good way for me to get some more stone so I can make some more slabs for slabbing the nether. It is really almost complete. It does seem that the Wither Skeleton Farm spawns a lot of mobs. Unfortunately, it spawns a lot of pigmen, and I'm sort of creating a panic room area that I saw on Seth Bling's channel. So we're going to 0, 0 there. So here we go. Let's do that and put that. And there we go. So we should meet up with our little hallway, I think. Let's see. Hey, there it is. Okay, so like I said, we don't want that. But we are going to want this area dug out anyway, so I'm just marking it so that we know that this area all here, inside here and including this little ring, is all the slime chunk. And let me dig it out, and then we'll do a little proof of concept, see if a slime spawns, and then we'll continue. Because if I've done this incorrectly, no sense in you know, going way too far with this. So I'll be back once I clear this out. What a letdown, guys. I cleared it out, and I've been standing here, like, close, and then I've gone about this far, waited, and then, like, off this way a little bit further and waited, and nothing. I mean, not a single spawn. Because, you know, you sometimes have to get away. I haven't gotten a single one to spawn. So I don't know what that means. Maybe I misidentified the chunk, or maybe that, you know, that there are places, caves that are eating up the spawn space. I don't know. Highly disappointing at this point, because I really wanted to make a slime farm. I don't know where these guys are coming from. That he's not the first one. Get out of here. So anyway, just, I don't know. We're not going to do that today. you know, and you know what else is annoying? Over here, listen, you hear that? This is in a slime chunk. And you know what? That might be helpful in that website. I'm going to look that up with these coordinates and see, because I have had them appear down here. So this must be a slime chunk in this area, because unless they open the door or something, are they out here? No. Okay, so like I said, in here is a slime chunk, which is annoying, and they do sometimes, but now that I think about it, they don't form that often, or they don't spawn that often. So I think that most likely I did identify it properly. It's just that I have to make multiple floors for them to spawn. And the great thing is, assuming that it works, it'll be completely AFK with hoppers and stuff, and we'll be able to collect the slime balls and then make lots of slime blocks. So instead, I am going to, we're going to go check out the Wither Skeleton Farm, because it's just, I was just thinking, no, okay, never mind. I, for some reason, I thought those were slime blocks. So, yeah, let's see. Do we have everything we need? Oh, I forgot to put the anvil down. Ugh. I made another anvil because it broke, but I forgot to put it down. Oh, you know what? I'll just do this. And then keeping it in there, next time I go over there, it'll be there. Cool. What else? Okay, cool. We've got armor, which I had forgotten about, and I got into a fight with one of those zombies, and I was down to like half health, and I was like, what? He hit me twice. Okay, anyway. Cool story, bro. okay, I'll be back once I get to the place in the Nether. Oh, I'm gonna bring some materials with me too. So let me grab those, and yeah, I'll be back with you guys in a second. Oh, now this is fun. What is... I don't know why this happens. Ugh. Ugh. All right, yeah, we're gonna need that panic room. Oh my god, no, 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 no! We're going the wrong way! There it goes, it's gone. Baby zombie big man! Oh no, wait, never mind. Just a baby zombie pig man dying. I thought it was one on a chicken. Chicken jockey. I mean, it could have been, but I don't really know what it was. But anyway, I've done a lot. I mean, I don't know how many other places I need to slab, but it seems to me that I've done a good enough job that they're starting to spawn on my rail tracks, which to me means pretty successful. The thing is, it's funny because like you sort of encounter... I have no idea why they're spawning here, but yep, okay, good. I don't know where he's coming from, but he should not have been able to spawn anywhere on this path. yeah, anyway, you'll go into like a small cave area. You'll be like, oh, I missed some spots over there. You'll be like, oh, you know, I'll slab this area, and oh, there's a little opening right here. Let me just slab those two blocks. And then you look inside, you're like, oh my gosh, there's a whole underground, whole underground area. But as you can see, the Nether is super snowy, and I don't know where these, I'm sure, well, you know what it is. It's the fact that they're, see like that, you see that? There's that one block that I missed, and they spawn on it, and that was a bad idea. But I didn't hear any other ones get mad, so fine, whatever. All right, I'm not afraid of you. Hopefully he's out of range enough of any that are in there. We're going to find out in a second if there are any in here. But as you guys can see, on those little spots, they're actually spawning, which means that all of this area here is very well protected from being spawned on, for the most part. So that should be effective. And there's the Wither Skeleton right there. I want to say that I've put down 30,000 blocks, maybe. I'm not really sure. It's a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot, a lot. It has taken me, I'd say, 20 to 30 hours here. Oh, man. It is working very, very well. Better than the other times when I was in the Nether. I guess, like, unloading and reloading this. Oh, man. Okay, now. Oh, the other thing, guys. So, look. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, like right here alone on this level. Okay, so one thing I did do, as you guys can tell, I raised the roof to 2.5. It was at 2, and what was happening is these guys are 2.5 tall. And well, actually, their sword makes it 3 blocks, but they can spawn in a 2.5 tall area. They were spawning in the 2 high area, but they were suffocating because it was covering their heads. So, and I found also that the top level never ever spawned wither skeletons. So it's now only 3 levels tall, which saved me some wooden planks, or not wooden planks, stone slabs. Okay, all right, so here we go. Let's see if we can get ourselves a little Zelda sound, guys. All right. Oh, there's another one. And also the other thing is too, while you guys might think that the fire aspect and the looting doesn't quite work, that's not entirely true, because what happens is, like, for example, if I were to throw poison at these guys and switch quickly to my looting sword, it would count as a looting kill, which is the same if I kill them with my sword and the fire aspect. But it doesn't set them on fire anyway, so we don't have to worry about that. It's actually the sword kill that kills them, and we're probably not going to get anything out of these guys. All right, now we got to be careful with the pigmen. Okay, they're not mad. But here's the other thing. That I kind of want to deal with. Maybe we can deal with it right now. And then, well, if I do this, we can, yeah, you know what? We can, let's, okay, right. I was going to do this anyway because I brought all this stuff. I think I brought everything. Yeah, okay. Hey, a regular skeleton. Okay, see, they catch on fire. Let's kill the magma cube. The thing is, these guys take up spawn space from the wither skeletons, of course, and so do those guys. And these guys we can't really kill without getting in trouble. So, let's build ourselves something right here. And it's really simple. All you really need is, well, we need some blocks. So let me go get some of those. All you need to do is use a piston, to crush things, and a sticky piston to pull it back. Here we go. We'll just, yeah, netherrack is fine, isn't it? No, I don't want to use netherrack because it's ugly. Because, oh gosh, that guy scared me. All right, so I think we have enough of these that we can make a good amount of these blocks here. Come on, let's go. There we go. And wait, that's not how you do it, idiot. All right, there. Okay, and then, yeah, maybe enough. I'm not sure. There we go. Whatever. Close enough. That's close. 34? Maybe enough. Could be enough. I think there was like one more in here or something. Oh, and I've got slabs. No, I don't want slabs. Okay, let's try it. So we're just going to make... Oh, geez. It repopulated. Well, wow. This thing is efficient. It actually does what I wanted it to do. And seriously, the thing is, I really do want to fix this, because we have blazes that I want to be able to shoot at, and I don't want to have to worry about hitting zombie pigmen. And eventually what will happen is, if I don't clear the zombie pigmen, it's just going to fill up. All right. It's just going to fill up with them. So, oh man, this is working excellent. Look at it. I mean, I just walked to the other edge and more form. So awesome. This is great. And I see magma cubes jumping down there. So let me create this little room here. And then I don't need your sword, buddy. Ah, gosh. Okay, so let's do this, and we're gonna back out here. I could have gotten that. So we'll want to do this. Oh, and I turned up the gamma for you guys. Well, I will. When I put out the video, just because some people let me know that it was kind of hard to see when I'm in the Nether. So I hope that you guys like what I did. I don't know how it's gonna look, so I'm just saying that in advance. So we want them to walk in right here. Do we want it here? I'm gonna let them in one more block. So we'll put it here. And so all we need to do, guys, is take a piston and put it like right here. And then we put a block there. Ah, and we're gonna need an opening here so that we can, and we're gonna need a block up there. Nope. Come on. I need a block like right there. Yes. Okay. And then our lever, and this should toggle the piston. There we go. So there we go. We got that. We can leave that part open. I don't really think the light level is going to, well, we can close that off. And then we need, a pressure plate. Yeah, I think, so we got that there. We need, I was going to say, I didn't bring redstone. Okay. So that block, then we need nothing there. Yeah, because that's where it's going to come down on them. Then we need a piece of redstone, and then we just need a pressure plate. Oh, right. No, we do need something there to keep them away from us. So that's where they're going to get killed. This is our block. Sorry, guys. I should have thought this out a little bit better first. Okay. Jeez, I thought somebody was going to push me in there. What am I looking for? Piston. Okay, and we'll put a piston here. Like so. And so now they can't get past it. Then they'll get crushed by that. Right. And then need one more block on the end here where we can our little escape. And you guys are really smart. So I'm pretty sure you guys know what I'm doing here. Fairly simple, guys, is this. We just put a pressure plate down here, like so, and put this on it like that. All right, cool. So now all we do is leave here, and this thing is so efficient. Okay, all right. Jeez, I need to eat something. Let's eat something first. But, where'd all those pigmen go? We've got a bunch of blazes, and so here's what happens, guys. So let's do this. Let's get him angry at us. Ugh, I totally missed. All right, come here. And you run over here, and you take out this block. Can I even, let's go over this way. Yeah, okay, I can reach it there, right? Well, he didn't even come. You have to bait him over, I guess. Oh, he died. Well, oh, and I got a gold ingot. Nice. in theory, guys, I guess we don't really need it because it seems like things keep, if you move far enough away, they despawn and respawn as, the mob that we want. Okay. So he's mad. So I killed one, right? And he's mad at me. So I'm going to bait him over here. Come on. Oh, they're scary. Okay. And he's going to come in here. He's going to be like, dude, let me in. And I'm going to go, yeah, well, you and your buddies, let's assume there are eight of them or so. Just do that. And you kill them indirectly, so you can kill off the pigmen without making other pigmen angry. And there you go. And then you walk off, and we're all set. And we've cleared out the pigmen in that level. We got a skelly there. So let's check the other levels, make sure they're functioning. And if they are, guys, I mean, this to me is a complete Wither Skeleton Farm, and I did say that when it was completed, what I would do is give you guys a level download, so I think I can do that. I don't know if I showed you guys this feature, but you go this way and kind of get out of the way of that for a few seconds, come back, and it should sort of respawn, despawn. Let's see what happens. Okay, well, in theory, but it could be that the lower levels. Oh, I changed the staircase. I like this better. It's a little bit nicer. Oh geez. Okay. Well, oh geez. Oh, baby big man. Ooh. Oh, one heart. Oh my God. Oh boy. Those guys are mean. So yeah, you guys see why we need a panic room. Ideally want one on every floor. That was really bad. And I have decent armor. Kill this guy. Come on, give me that Zelda sound. Ah. All right. I am not leaving until we get at least one Wither Skeleton skull. But as you guys can see, well, at least on the other level, it was going pretty well there for a bit. And I don't know why that took so many shots to kill him. Is pumpkin pie any good food? I grabbed it out of my chest. I don't usually eat it. Is it like a cookie or is it better? Because, man, I need some... I need some support here. All right, there we go. You die too. Okay. Golly, that was... Okay, look. Okay, so are they mad? Because if they are, I'm going downstairs. No, they wouldn't be because they were just spawned, right? Is that how that works? Yeah, so they aren't mad because they are new. Cool. Okay, so that... Well, that's reassuring. I guess it makes sense. I just didn't know that about them. But it does make sense. Okay, so... Anyhow, let's go check the bottom level now. And you guys, the paths and everything are on the top level. So here we go. Oh, geez, not this again. Oh, God. All right, this is bad. Okay, so yeah, yeesh. Man. Okay. Gotta take it easy here. Oh boy, he's mad. I see him. You're mad. These guys weren't in range apparently, but I guess they can't get around that. All right, let's see here. They can't get around the staircase that I made. But you know what's funny? Like, I think riding in the minecart seems to be the best way to get the guys or to get the wither skeleton spawns, because I'm not really seeing any. Okay, come on, jeez. Die already, please. Are you mad? He is. Alright. Good. I'm glad that I built these stairs the way that I did and they can't really get past them very well. Because these guys are mean. Like, super duper mean. Alright, so. Ooh, that was risky there. Alright, so I hear more. Made a little bit of a gold farm here too. Come on. Yep, bring it. Alright. Come on. Okay, so we've got blazes. Blaze, and oh, look at that. See, these, and I think these guys were the original spawns from when we came in with the minecart. Ugh, come on. You know, it's a good thing that wither skeletons aren't like pigmen. Come on, really? I hear blaze. I'm not leaving until I get it. They are not, we have to get one. Wow, we got 42 coal, so. So here's your coal farm too, guys. Renewable coal. you know, most things are renewable in Minecraft. The one thing that really isn't are diamonds. Okay, here we go. No. Oh, no. Finally, Mr. Baby Zombie, look, you see it? I don't know how many that was, guys, but I will put a count on the screen for how many it took to get that one Wither Skeleton Skull. I'm guessing it's around 100. Wow, look at all those guys spawn. Watch another one drop right here. Wouldn't that be crazy? Technically, 3 should drop, because if I've killed 100 and I have like a 3-4% chance, it should all drop at once. But anyway, guys, this is working. I'm going to give you guys a new level download in the description. What I'll do is finish off here. And as you guys can see, wow, I went through almost a full stack of bread here. But you know, we ended up with a lot of blaze rods, a lot of magma cubes. Magma cream. Wish I had a good use for those. I mean, I guess fire resistance potion is pretty good, but be nice if they were, you know, if it was more fuel related. But anyway, the zombie pigmen and pigmen in here, you do need to be careful of. They do have a hard time going up and down my staircase, so that does make it a little bit easier to deal with them, but they are not easy to deal with, so just be careful of that. Because when you make one mad, they all get mad, and they're always going up and down the stairs, coming after you, and they are very, very powerful enemies. They're scary, too, when they're right at you like that. I'm going to skip this. Just check in for a couple more Wither Skeletons, just in case, because I'm a little bit addicted. And that is my second Wither Skeleton skull, so a third one would be nice, because then you could fight the Wither. Darn. Okay, so anyway, guys, I am going to let you go, and go ahead, link in the description to the new world download with all the changes that have been made up until this point. If you enjoyed this episode, well, I guess not too much happened in it, but I did demonstrate that this works. If you enjoyed this episode and you're happy about the level world download that you guys have been asking for many, many, many episodes, here it is. Please go ahead, show your support, give this video a like. If this is your first time watching one of my videos and you haven't subscribed, become a noodler today. It's free and fun. Go ahead, click that subscribe button. All right, I'll see you guys again soon. Thanks for watching, and of course, noodle on.